He tried to eat that. You got him.
Oh, that was hardcore.
You got me hooked on fishing now.
New American Sportsman is presented by Miller High Life.
The blue waters of Florida play host to thousands of vacationers every year. From sailing to scuba diving to sport fishing, the Sunshine State offers everything under the sun. But away from the surf of Florida's coast lies Lake Okeechobee, a more than 700 square mile body of fresh water that feeds the Everglades and is known as one of the greatest bass fisheries in the world. Okeechobee is home to several bass tournaments throughout the year and a likely contender to produce the next bag of fish capable of beating bass angler Byron Velvick's three-day weight record of more than 83 pounds. Velvick is best known for his stint on ABC's hit television series, The Bachelor. It's where he landed his best catch to date. Fiancée Mary Delgado is a Florida native, but has yet to fish for largemouth bass or with her prospective husband.
Mary and I are looking forward to finally spending time together. I look forward to actually going out on a boat with her and spending a day, just her and I, you know, traveling around and fishing a little bit and then going back to where she lives and spending time in Tampa. We're just starting to spend a lot more time enjoying each other's company.
Joining the couple is New American Sportsman host Tom Ackerman. A lifelong outdoorsman, Tom has hunted and fished from coast to coast, but has yet to wet a line in the Okeechobee's famed waters.
Byron, there's no love in fishing, is there?
Doesn't love end at the water's edge?
Yeah, I mean, love ends at the water's edge, but if I have her in the boat with me, there better be a little love, otherwise I'm gonna be the bachelor again. That's the problem.
Despite the rough weather conditions, the trio still seems to be having fun. But after a visit to Slim's bait shop, the talk of fishing turns to football.
Okay, you have an idea. Lay it on.
The biggest fish gets this.
Okay.
Since I'm going to win, you have to get me drinks during the game, the football game.
Okay.
You have to be my servant.
I'll serve you.
Because you know the Colts are going to win.
Mary loves football, and it came out that Tom was actually a big Patriots fan, while Mary had an affinity for the Colts. They got into a little battle regarding the two of them and which team was going to win, and I think the competition on fishing that day was whoever caught the biggest fish had to have the other person serve them drinks and wings and food during the game, because that evening, after fishing was over, we were all going to watch the playoffs, which was the Patriots versus the Colts.
Well, as soon as I stepped out of the bait shop and I saw what the weather was like on the first day of fishing, I was thinking to myself, ooh, I do not like being cold. I was thinking long johns.
The weather's always the wild card. You don't really have any control over that. What you do have control over is your attitude. And these folks both have really good attitudes.
Yee-hoo! This is fun, baby. This is your favorite part.
They've been through the whole Bachelor series together, but they had never spent any time on the water together. I was a little surprised that this was the first time that she'd ever been on a boat with him and gone fishing.
Having a guide like lifelong Floridian Mark Shepherd on board means Byron can take a break from the pressures of professional bass fishing.
This was kind of fun because we actually went shiner fishing, and I got to take Mary out and relax. That was the best part, was this time you get to relax and not go out and be, you know, pre-fishing for a competition. I've never fished shiners myself. I've seen a lot of people doing it, but to go out and throw bobbers and let a live bait swim around and wait for a bass to come to you is a completely different method of fishing for me.
This is the only time you'll see me hugging her on a bass boat, right about here, where I'm shiner fishing, relaxing. You want to see tournaments? Get away from me, honey. Get back, honey. I got work. Leave me alone. Give me a cheese sandwich.
Despite the weather, it's not long before the fish of the Okeechobee start biting.
Eat my fish.
Bring it on, baby.
Oh.
Mary has a hook set that is impressive. I think she has a natural talent for this whole fishing thing, and I look forward to seeing her do it some more, especially in regards to fishing tournaments and practicing.
I would love to go out and pre-fish with Byron. It's very intriguing to me. I really like going out there and learning as much as there is to know about bass fishing. I'm a student at this point, and Byron is teaching me. Daggummit.
She got off to a slow start. She had a bite early on. She lost the fish, just didn't get a good hook set, or for whatever reason, that fish came unstuck. But to her credit, she stuck with it. She had a couple other bites that didn't work out, and finally. All right.
This is my element right here. It's just being outdoors, just enjoying God's creation. So this was really important to me to see Byron in his own element.
Next on the New American Sportsman.
Do I have to kiss this?
Yes. Yeah. Well, you caught it yourself. Mwah.
Everyone wants it, basketball's got it. ESPN College Game Day, Saturdays at 11.
Fueled by Mountain Dew.
Nice wrench work, Chief. If more men would heed the call of the Y chromosome, maybe more of us would have three such faucets at our fingertips. Hot. Cold. And Miller High Life.
The Trojan forces couldn't be stopped. USC is number one again. Sports Illustrated honors the back-to-back champion USC Trojans with this exclusive national championship package, free with your paid subscription. This special SI National Championship hardbound commemorative book is a celebration of USC football. It's individually numbered, a collector's issue that's a must-have keepsake for every Trojan fan. Call now and you'll also get this USC Championship football with the Orange Bowl and USC logos, designed exclusively for Sports Illustrated. Both are free when you order 56 issues of SI for only $1.59 an issue. Save 60% off the cover price. When you use your credit card, you'll also get this collectible mini helmet, recognizing USC's second consecutive championship free. Celebrate the Trojans with three great gifts from Sports Illustrated.
To order, call 1-800-245-9200. That's 1-800-245-9200. Or go online at sitvoffer.com.
ESPN2's presentation of The New American Sportsman is brought to you by Miller High Life. To live simply, proudly, boldly, manly, this is the High Life.
For Byron Velvick and Mary Delgado, the fishbowl existence on ABC's hit series The Bachelor has finally drawn to a close. With New American Sportsman host Tom Ackerman, they get away for a little time on Florida's Lake Okeechobee.
Ooh. Come over here.
Oh.
Grannell!
Come to Papa. No, that's a bass.
Oh, he's a little, look at him. Can you believe that fish tried to eat that bait? Isn't that something?
Oh, look at that. What do you want to be when you grow up?
What a cute
but I want to give you guys the image here. So let's just show you what that fish just ate.
Yeah.
Aren't they mad?
That's amazing.
You know, bass fishing is bass fishing, and just to get bit and to catch a bass of any size, it was fun. I actually just like catching fish, and it wouldn't matter what the size are.
It's a 12-incher, it's a 4-pounder. It's like, look at the size of that, yeah, look at that, woo, big bass.
Hold it close
big
to
bass.
The camera.
That one's about 9 or 10, wouldn't you say, Jimmy Houston?
You guys, you know all the tricks. I'll tell you, well, you're shameless, absolutely shameless. If this was your first date with Byron, would there be a second?
Yeah.
Okay, just checking.
Hey, you hesitated. Ow, you hesitated on that. What the hell is that all about?
I had to think about it.
I don't like the fact you had to think about it.
I had to give an honest answer.
The day you catch a 10-pounder, I upgrade that ring. I'll put an extra carrot on that ring.
Brother, they embellish a little bit.
Another guy brought over a legitimate 10-pound bass. That's the first double-digit bass, live bass, that I've ever seen. And I'm telling you, it was dandy. It was an absolute beautiful largemouth.
Hello, pretty. You're going to live. We're going to let you go, okay?
I like to be able to catch a double-digit bass like that, because I think that's what a lot of anglers strive for. So it was exciting to me to be out on Lake Okeechobee and actually witness that.
All right. Yes. Another 10 pounds. Yes!
Good job, honey.
Oh!
Oh!
Yes! It counts! It counts! Yes.
Counts!
All right! Way to go!
Look how he ate it, honey. Look at the tail.
Man, oh, man. That's the smartest fish in the lake. Smartest fish in the lake, man.
And we can still use the bait.
It's nice to see Mary catch bass. It's nice to see her go bass fishing. It's nice to see her have success and actually catch her first one. And ultimately, I think it's the beginning of many. I hope that she falls in love with the sport like I love the sport. But if she doesn't, that's okay too. I just think that it's exciting that she actually has tried out my passion. And to see her catch her first fish was neat. And to be a part of that. And it wasn't just her first fish ever, but of course it was her first largemouth bass. And that's something you always remember.
My first one? Do I have to kiss this?
Yes. Well, you caught it yourself.
Mwah. You're gonna live, little fishy.
So we switched from fishing live baits to flipping the mats, what they call the hydrilla mats. Really, it's kind of a finesse way of fishing, and it's not an easy way to fish.
And ultimately, that's why the flippers have the advantage. They go in there, and they're good at hitting targets. They're good at getting in there and picking out the little details, idiosyncrasies, figuring out exactly what those fish are looking for.
So how good are you at flipping?
Oh, I suck. Oh, I suck.
Look at you. That was pretty cool.
Like that?
That was awesome. That
I bit the first time on this one. I was like, 10 pounder.
That was cool. Nice work.
To me, when you go flipping, you're constantly, it's a constant movement. It's artificial bait, so you have to work a lot harder for your bass.
Look at you go.
So to me, I certainly enjoyed flipping more than I did fishing with shiners.
The Basslerette.
That was gonna stick.
Yeah.
Uh-oh. She's got a flip fish!
Oh, man. Talk to me, talk to me.
Baby.
Yes!
That's a special fish. That's the first. Now, granted, he's not going to win big fish of the day, but here you go. Put your hand on it. Go ahead and lip him. You got to put your thumb in there, and you lip him, and you let him go.
Set him back. Bye, sweetie.
Your first artificial fish to be a flip fish is okay. Awesome. That is great.
Mary's in the club.
I'm in the flipping club.
Do you know how cool it is you just flipped a fish? Mary has a natural ability for fishing. I can see that she's an outdoors girl to begin with. And she picked up on everything very quickly, especially, I think I'm still shocked and stunned that her very first artificial was a flip fish.
Next on the New American Sportsman.
What am I doing? I'm surfing the net. Stick around, I'm going to show you some of the best outdoor internet sites around.
You know, ideas and inventions come from people in all walks of life, and most of the century's top inventions came from individuals, not companies. Do you have an idea for a new product or invention? Are you interested in trying to submit your idea to companies for a good faith review and in trying to patent it as well? If so, Invention Submission Corporation has information to help you get started. ISC is America's largest inventor service firm with over 50 offices nationwide. Call this toll-free number now to see how to get this free information. The information includes forms to assure confidentiality, a form to record and date your idea, plus an informative brochure that explains how to submit your idea to companies through ISC's data bank and how to apply for a patent. Even if you only have an idea for improving an existing product, you'll want to call now for ISC's free information.
For your inventor's information, call toll-free 1-800-652-0101. That's 1-800-652-0101.
On the next tilt.
Opportunity just flew in on a private jet. If I clear my throat before I raise, then you re-raise. You understand?
Let's rock and roll.
Tilt, Thursday at 9 p.m. on ESPN, presented by Toyota.
Winter X Games 9, live from Aspen, starts Saturday and continues nightly at 9 Eastern on ESPN.
$50,000, so your gym becomes my gym.
I know how we can raise the money. Car wash.
When things look their worst, the average Joes are at their best.
What's our team motto?
Aim low.
That's right.
Now he's a philosophizer.
You can dodge a wrench, you can dodge a ball.
Dodgeball, a true underdog story.
On in-demand pay-per-view. Get it now from Cox Digital Cable.
Instant Access, presented by Miller High Life.
I think all great adventures start right here at home when you're dreaming about them. And the internet is an incredible resource. Right now I'm looking at AmericanParkNetwork.com. So this is a great site because it's just going to show you a lot of what's available for free in the American Park system. Getting some ideas about different activities that are available there. Everything from water skiing, snow sports, rock climbing, boating, rafting. It's your complete guide to the parks. Another amazing thing to use the internet for is gear. At www.backpacker.com is a place that I found some of my most recent goodies, the hand crank backcountry blender. Now you see why man invented electricity. The one cup espresso maker. Just kind of cool to see like all the new gear that's available these days. There's my cell phone, another piece of technology.
For Bass's three-day weight record holder, Byron Velvet, tough fishing conditions and rough weather made for a challenging day on Lake Okeechobee. With the wind still raging, Byron and Mary take a little time off the water to try their hand at the Palm Beach Shooting Center.
The next date that Mary and I are going on is actually going to be a shooting range, and we're going to go out and wield weapons and shoot at targets.
Before the couple can hit the range, it's time for a refresher course on the tenets of gun safety.
Okay, now the firearm is loaded and there is a round in the chamber. I go ahead and position the gun in your hand just like that. Put your front sight on the target where you want.
All right.
Fire the pistol, and when you're ready, go ahead and just pull the trigger nice and slowly. Good shot.
Hit him on the nose.
Get him on the nose.
I think I should hit him on the forehead.
No, you're doing good. Fire three rounds. You've got 10 rounds left in the gun, okay?
All right, just keep going.
I've never picked up a handgun. My heart was beating so fast. I think that a weapon is a weapon. It's the person that's behind the weapon that's the danger. You know, it was real scary for me to handle.
Good for shooting. He started off straight, then he started leaning off to the side.
Okay.
Blah, 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 blah.
No, at least didn't go that
way. First shot was the important one.
You're up. You ready?
Yep.
Behind the rear, and go ahead and pull the trigger when you're comfortable. Good shot. There you go, that was a good shot. Now do that same exact thing and you'll be set. Good. Go. Got it.
Are we not gonna go again?
You're gonna get the machine gun now.
Machine gun?
We have a Uzi submachine gun, which is a 9mm caliber. To let them fire off a couple magazines for all to see how a full auto firearm works. Pushing the button, pull back the bolt. All right, you're ready to go. Okay, good. Just kind of aim a little lower now because it's going to want to go up. Good. Same thing. Good. Same thing. Okay. That was a fast 20 rounds.
Wow.
All right. Go ahead and we'll unload it. There you go.
It was a first-time experience for me to fire a full automatic weapon. So it was a rush. My heart was beating very fast, and I know I don't want to handle another one again. it was real scary for me.
There you go. That was. But it was good because you hit the target.
I did, okay.
You scraped it.
But now you're out of rounds. You're just
in your rounds.
It was fun. I felt like Rambo.
Next on the New American Sportsman.
Got him. Oh, that was hardcore.
Real fishermen stand up.
Sorry.
Hey! Notre Dame, right?
ESPN's coming to the Walt Disney World Resort. Join us in Florida for ESPN The Weekend. Go to ESPNTheWeekend.com now.
Look at that eyesore. That litter might as well be a shove to the elbow of a billiards player. A man picks up after himself. And, when called upon, after others. After all, the high life is a clean game. No slop.
Discover the hitting secrets of America's finest baseball school in a professional instructional videotape. Teaching the mechanics of the Major League Swing features professional scout and instructor Tommy Mansky and the same award-winning tested under fire techniques that have produced baseball world's back-to-back-to-back AAU national championship teams. Coach Mansky's studied analysis of thousands of baseball's best professional swings has yielded a no less than revolutionary approach to consistent hitting. It's proven, and you'll love its easy-to-understand, step-by-step video training methods. Teaching the mechanics of the Major League Swing benefits players of all ages and ability levels. A valuable addition to any coach's library, too, and it makes a great gift. Thousands have been sold at $39.95, but if you'll call now and use your credit card, you'll pay only $29.95. To order, call toll-free 1-800-344-8300. That's 1-800-344-8300. This is the video that gets results.
ESPN2's presentation of The New American Sportsman is brought to you by Miller High Life. To live simply, proudly, boldly, manly, this is The High Life.
What am I doing? I'm surfing the net. Stick around, I'm going to show you some of the best outdoor internet sites around.
Let's check out www.shotgunsports.com. I got kicked out of my typing class in high school. You just plug in what state you live in, and it'll tell you all of the skeet shooting, trap shooting, and hunting locations near you. This is just an incredible resource. Put in your state, who knows, it could be a great place to shoot 5 miles up the road from you.
Rough weather, tough fishing made for a long day on Florida's Lake Okeechobee. But after blowing off a little steam at the shooting range, the bachelor, Byron Velvick, and fiance, Mary Delgado, are ready to hit the water and try again. With the weather front moving on, the skies have cleared, but the fishing will prove even tougher.
Tom basically abandoned us the second day after fishing with the first day and making good friends. He immediately upgraded to a day in the Bahamas marlin fishing, and ultimately we were stuck with the very bad conditions of a cold front having passed through, bluebird skies, and not at all exact the temperature to catch bass, and not at all the weather you'd want in order to do well in tournaments.
What a twist of fate. Instead of being out here practicing and fishing the FLW tournament this week, I'm down here shiner fishing with my fiance, showing her a little bit about what bass fishing is in a much more relaxed format. It's kind of nice to be out here and taking her out on the water and seeing her catch her first bass, and for the most part, I'm pretty excited about the fact that she's able to enjoy this at a slower pace. It's unusual for me to be at a slow pace, but shiner fishing on Okeechobee's, it's a first for me.
Are we ready to rock and roll? Are we going to the spot?
The sweet spot! Oh, just like
the wheel.
Car?
That's the wheel. That's a car. And there's the wheel. You just turn it and drive it. Have fun. You'll be driving a lot of boats. That's a no-wake zone. Don't go too fast. What are you doing?
Eating my fish.
You got one?
Yep.
My God, you do. Honey, what the hell?
Oh, got back on it. Did you get back on it?
Feel him.
Come on, get on it. Get on it, little fishy.
She's eating the scales off it and everything. Oh! Look at
this! Dang it!
That's fine.
Wait. Oh, shoot, now I'm all tangled up. I gotta put it back in.
You got him. Oh, that was hardcore. Good job, honey.
Fight that one.
Ultimately, it was exciting to take her out and watch her just get into baiting the hook herself and throwing the bobber out there with the float on it, or and letting the shiner swim around. And I think it's different for me. She's going to get a different taste of it when the tour starts. So right now, she got a taste of a different type of fishing. Let's take that guy and just let's toss him out there somewhere.
He's having fun right there.
You really need to just let me cast it for you.
He's having fun right there. He's enjoying himself.
He'll have a lot more. This is
but
not
he's
about
having fun.
This
let
is
him
not
have
about
fun.
Protecting the shiner. This is about making the shiner work
let
for another fish.
It. I want to cast it.
No, you just.
I want to cast it.
You just hold on. There we go.
But
right on top
right
of the other.
That's right next to my other bobber.
Well, here I'll reel him in a little bit then. Mary and I got to focus a little bit more on fishing with each other, and I got to show her a couple tricks and kind of help. Talk her along the way of catching bass, and it was fun. It was nice to actually just have a little bit of one-on-one time. Now you're actually fishing. Doesn't that feel good?
All right.
Feels good to actually be fishing instead of just watching a shiner swim around by the side of the boat, huh? Boy, this is our time. This isn't about you and me and the fish. It's about you and me. But if you'll excuse me now, I'm going to go to this fish.
When you go fishing, and you go as a couple, you've got a beautiful, serene place where you just sit and you wait for your fish to hit. So what a better time to sit there and really talk to your significant other and really learn about that person. So to me, it was a beautiful, serene place where Byron and I can actually talk with one another and learn more about each other.
Oh, yeah, that's nice. Nice the way you're catching all the fish. You're sitting in that big old comfy chair. You sure you don't want to sit down?
Real fishermen stand up.
You know, I stand up when there's money on the line. I don't see no paycheck on the line right about now.
You know, Lance. You love when I kid with you. Let me give you a kiss.
There's no better place to find a common bond than in the out-of-doors, where a man's passion can transcend the difficulties and offer a glimpse into the character of their companions.
Mary and I really enjoy just having time together, and it's nice to have the pressure of reality TV and The Bachelor kind of behind us.
I would like to think that the future holds a lot of fishing together, a lot of quiet time, just being a normal couple.
Ultimately now we're just starting to spend a lot more time enjoying each other's company and finding time to walk on the beach and finding time to go to restaurants and have dinner and all that together.
Byron and Mary, this is just the beginning of many days on the water together. A place to grow in the outdoor experience. The experience of the new American sportsman.
This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. Become a better outdoorsman. Log on to ESPNOutdoors.com. Coming up.